Hey, Tony, are you building a dog kennel? Awesome. But remember to be careful. See, you almost stepped on a nail, and that can be very dangerous. Even a small nail can cause you a lot of problems. Let's see why. First, it will hurt, unless of course you are an experienced yogi and walk on nails every day. Secondly, the nail damages the skin and internal tissues. It can damage blood vessels and cause bleeding, and the wound could get infected. Then there are consequences that are not so obvious. First, small pieces of rust from the nail can detach and remain in the wound, causing severe irritation and prolonged pain. And the biggest hazard is the bacteria that cover the nail in large quantities. There's a lot of stuff that sticks to a nail that's lying on the ground. The most dangerous one you've probably heard of is Clostridium tetani, which causes tetanus. It is a disease that affects the nervous system and causes seizures and even respiratory failure. The disease is caused by a toxin released by bacteria. After contracting the infection, it spreads from the affected limb to the opposite limb, then to the torso, neck, head, and then you start having seizures. Respiratory and cardiac muscle paralysis may come later. In nature, the bacterium lives in the soil of gardens, farms, pastures, and other places where human and animal fecal contamination is present. It also lives freely in the intestines, but it's harmless there because the toxin doesn't pass through the mucous membranes and doesn't enter the bloodstream. Yes, this bacterium is found almost all over the globe, but the chance of getting infected is not the same everywhere. The more humid and hotter the environment, the higher the chance to be affected. Also, if you are wounded, you need to treat the wound immediately. So in countries where medicine is underdeveloped, the chances of catching tetanus are much higher. If you get a wound, you should clean it immediately with clean water, treat it with hydrogen peroxide, and bandage it up. Do not hesitate to seek medical attention, because the more time passes, the more bacteria will multiply and the worse the consequences will be. Tetanus doesn't manifest itself immediately. It usually takes about 8 days, but sometimes it can be even longer. Headaches, irritability, sweating, muscle tension, and twitching around the wound may precede the disease. Chills, insomnia, yawning, sore throat when swallowing, back pain, and loss of appetite are noted immediately before the onset of the disease. However, the incubation period may be asymptomatic. Then you will feel the pain at the site of the wound, which by this time, in most cases, has already healed. Then, tension and contraction of the muscles of mastication begins, which greatly interferes with the consumption of food. In severe cases, if medical help is not provided in time, the patient won't be able to unclench their teeth on their own. The next stage of the disease involves numerous spasms. The first thing that can be noticed is a rictus grin, or spasm of the facial muscles. It can cause the eyebrows to rise, the mouth to stretch wide, and the patient seems to be trying to smile and cry at the same time. Then, painful cramps occur, limited at first and then spreading to larger muscle groups, lasting from a few seconds to several minutes. In mild cases, cramps occur several times a day. In severe cases, they almost never stop. Depending on the tension of one or another muscle group, the patient's body may assume the most bizarre poses. The patient bends in bed in an arched position, leaning only on the heels and back of the head, with the legs stretched, arms bent at the elbows, fists clenched. On top of that, the body temperature rises to 41 or even 42 degrees Celsius. Treatment usually takes 1 to 3 months. The patient is placed in a separate, darkened room with no bright lights or noise. During treatment, the patient cannot leave the bed and requires constant medical observation, and a tetanus serum is administered. Because of problems with the muscles of mastication, only liquid foods, such as broths and milk, have to be eaten during this period. Yes, the consequences are terrible, but don't be so afraid. Today, the chances of contracting tetanus are not that high. First of all, there is usually a first aid kit nearby, and even if there isn't, it's not that hard to get an appointment with a doctor. Second, there are vaccines against tetanus, which are given to people as children, and a vaccinated person has 50 times less chance of being infected. And the most important thing is to be careful. Try to avoid injuries, especially in dirty places, and treat any wounds in time, even if it's just a little scratch. After all, prevention is better than cure. And tell us in the comments all about your past injuries and wounds. The most unusual stories will appear in our next video. Bye-bye!